Hello friends, welcome to Technique. This is Nirmal here, and in this video we're gonna do a detailed review of the new Nokia 5.4. So Nokia 5.4 is the latest budget offering from Nokia in India, and this device is priced starting 13,999, that's 14,000 rupees, and you get a Snapdragon 662, 48 megapixel quad camera, 4000 mAh capacity battery, a 6.39 inches HD plus resolution display, and a stock Android experience under the Android One platform. So how good is the device? That's what we are going to talk about in this video. So we'll be analyzing all the aspects in detail, and we'll see how good the device is. So before starting the review, if this is your first time on this channel, do hit that red subscribe button and also hit the bell icon to get notified of all the videos we publish. So let's begin the review. So first, let's have a look at the design and build quality of the new Nokia 5.4. Now in terms of design, you can see that this device definitely looks quite good. You can see that the camera layout is a circular one, which is pretty neatly integrated. You get a fingerprint scanner, and you can also see there's a pattern on the back panel, which actually feels quite good. Now there is LED flash, the Nokia branding, and overall the back panel definitely looks quite okay in terms of design aspect. Now the front panel, you get a punch hole display. You can see that there is a punch hole 16 megapixel camera, which feels quite good. Again, the bezels aren't that too high. It's kind of pretty good in terms of the bezels as well. Now you get a 3.5mm audio jack, then USB Type-C port and the speaker unit. So overall we feel in terms of design, this is a fairly good looking device out there. Nothing exceptional out there, but then still a good looking device with the camera layout, and the in-hand feel also looks pretty good. Now moving on to the build quality. Now this is one area where Nokia has been continuously bringing down the quality, or rather if you look at the Nokia 5.1, 5.1 plus, they had a metal chassis and a glass finishing. Now here we don't get that. Now over the period of 2 years or 3 years, the build quality has come down drastically. Now we have a plastic frame and a plastic or polycarbonate material. Now polycarbonate versus glass finishing, that's debatable. Some people like polycarbonate because that won't break off when you fall, when the device falls, but glass might fall, but then glass gives a premium feel. So that's a debatable thing, but personally we feel the build quality is kind of average for the price segment, because Nokia had some great devices in terms of build quality, premiumness. Now that has come down with the Nokia 5.4. So that's the build quality. Now having said that, this polycarbonate feels quite okay. It is prone to scratches. You might have to use the case because over a period of time it might get scratched up quite easily. Now moving on to the display. So this is one area where we are kind of disappointed. At least at this price segment, Nokia should have given a full HD resolution display. Now the display isn't bad actually. It's kind of quite good. The colors are kind of okay, and the touch response also feels quite nice, but at 14,000 price segment we can't actually accept an HD plus resolution display. That's definitely not the display you expect in the 14K price segment. So that's one area where Nokia needs to work on, bring in a better display, and even the display protection is also not offered. So those things Nokia needs to improve, and at least for the next variant, the next iteration, we expect Nokia to get a full HD resolution if the pricing is going to be 15K. Now next, software. So this is one of the most important aspects about the Nokia devices, the software. So you get the stock Android experience, and this is under the Android One platform. So you get 2 years of security update patches. So Android 11 is slated to come for this device. In fact, it should have been Android 11 out of the box, but Nokia says this is coming soon. And Nokia is one of those brands which has provided updates on a timely manner, say even if it is Nokia 1 series or 2 series, 3 series, 4 series. Across the all the devices got the Nokia the Android 10 update last year. So you can expect Android 11 to be rolled out pretty soon, and even Android 12, whatever comes up next year, or rather this year, it should be available for the Nokia 5.4 as well. So that's one area where Nokia really excels. The software experience is really good. No bloatware, no ads, very clean and stock Android experience. This is something which many people want in their smartphone, clean and stock like UI with promised updates. So next step, the performance. So this is one area where Nokia 5.4 does a decent job altogether. The Qualcomm Snapdragon 662 is an entry level or kind of mid-range 600 series chipset. It's not a really powerful chipset, but it does a job pretty well. You can see that it's quite a smooth experience overall. No lags as such, and even multitasking also looks quite okay. It's not a laggy or an interface with issues, but it performs kind of smooth for the task it is put to. And again, if you look at the gaming experience, it's not a really a great device for gaming, because obviously 662 and an HD plus resolution display, you may not get the best experience, but you can play casual games. Now call quality is definitely good, and you get a dual SIM cards, dual VoLTE included, and we have tried with Jio and Vodafone, the two SIM cards we have, and we did not see any sort of issues. Now the speaker performance is quite good. Again, you can see the bottom firing speakers is quite good, and you get a fingerprint scanner on the back panel, which acts again quite well in terms of unlocking experience. Now moving on to the camera. So this is one area where Nokia says that they have improved drastically with the Nokia 5.4. This is a quad camera setup, 48 megapixel primary sensor, a 5 megapixel ultra wide, 2 megapixel macro and 2 megapixel depth sensor, and you get a 16 megapixel punch hole selfie camera as well. Now if you look at the camera, there are two things very important. One is Ozo Audio. So if you do video recording, the audio abilities are really good. The Ozo Audio definitely gets you really great audio experience, especially with the video recording. And second aspect is the cinema mode. Now cinema mode is something where you can record videos in H-Log, and you can actually edit the video for color correction. So a lot of things you can do with the video recording. Again, video recording you can do with stabilization, full HD supported. So you can go ahead and record videos in this format, and then later on edit them for color correction. This is something which is not available in this price segment. So these are something which are included in the Nokia 5.4. Now talking about the camera experience, the camera abilities are quite good. For the most part, daylight shots, it looks quite okay. And even in terms of colors, they're kind of accurate more or less. And they're not really saturated, or they do have a decent level of sharpness because it's a 48 megapixel shooter. If you ask me, are they the best? Definitely not. We'll be doing a detailed camera review later, so we'll talk about the camera in depth. Here are some samples we have taken with the Nokia 5.4, and we feel the Nokia camera has done kind of decent job altogether in the camera department. Now finally, the battery life. So Nokia 5.4 has a 4000 mAh capacity battery, and you get USB Type-C port, but a 10 watt charger. We are in 2021, and almost 15,000 price device having a 10 watt charger is definitely not an acceptable thing. At least 18 watt should have been there, but Nokia is saying that they are shipping only with a 10 watt charger, which will take more than 2 hours, I guess. We are not done the charging test, but it'll take a lot of time to charge. And the battery performance as such looks good. You can get like 1.5 days on an average user. Even if you are a heavy user, you will still get 1 day of battery life, which is quite okay. So battery life is kind of decent on the Nokia 5.4. So now summing up, how good is the Nokia 5.4? So the strengths of the Nokia 5.4 are the software, updates and the camera experience along with good battery life. Now it also looks decently well. Now the downsides include HD plus resolution display at this price segment, and then the build quality isn't that great, and on top of that the pricing is not competitive at all. It should have been lower than what has been announced. 13999 is definitely a higher price for the Nokia 5.4, but if you want stable updates and a great software experience along with decent performance, the Nokia 5.4 is a decent option right now, because none of the smartphones in the sub 15k price segment have Android One platform. So that's where Nokia excels. If you are particular about software updates, then below 15,000 Nokia 5.4 is a good option. So that was a detailed review of the Nokia 5.4. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. Do hit that like button and also hit the red subscribe button for more videos. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in our next video. Have a great day.